Okay, so now back to, what was it last time? The dependency. So this time it's the state index data. And then I'll move on to the others. So do we actually have this yet? No. This is also still in header, so let's actually split this up to be that, so I can actually get proper versus flow private. We do that. CMake lists includes add subdirectory. State YAML. We do that. So the only function I need to be known publicly is currently this one, right? Yeah. Okay, do it that way. I need the header. Include import.hpp, do that. Grab the header bit. Don't actually even need that. File system, great. Now we just have class foe search path. Whoops, search paths. Okay. Namespace. Expected function body declar. Oh, I'm missing there. Index file path. Index data file path. Okay. Expression that index file path. Search paths, index, okay. Equals, what was it? Index data. Okay, that should only be the last thing of him. Yep, is that. So, let's get this function into place. So returns a boolean. Takes in. Do I need that? Not really, I don't. I need the group name for exception or logging. Then otherwise, standard file system path. So this will be very similar to this, except we're going to then go into the node afterwards. YAML file, yeah, da da da. Change this to be a bit easier. File path, file path, file path. State dependencies, is there anything to do with that? Nope, there is not. But there would be for the ECS groups information. If I recall correctly. Yeah, okay. We're just going to have to pass it through. So, ECS groups. ECS groups. Oh, I already have it. Okay, we have OECS groups, and I'm going to pass it into this along with group name. ECS groups, we take that in, then we have the dependencies node and the ECS groups that we're doing. Would I actually import? It's not that, it'll be import index data from node. So rather than that, it'll be like ECS groups node. Realistically, I would be just passing in the node. So hold on, go to the declaration. Let's do this right. I'd be passing in ECS index generator. ECS group, pass the ECS group into there. We have this. Could not open YAML. Okay, that makes, that's common sense enough. Do not parse the independent dependencies file. The file path. Then it turns into this from node. Is that, do we have group name? Really, we do have, much like up here, it would just be, what, YAML? Yeah, okay. Just the node. Okay, back up here, go back to application. This one is pretty somewhere. Sorry, where is it? Did this stuff just go away? I don't know why I was on the main line. Okay, we're back here then. Import state data file. Da, 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 da. Let's state data. So it'd be YAML read index generator. So it'd be this, really. Which I presume would instead. It's a void function. Okay. Try this. We don't actually have this. Instead, we're just going to call into this. Return false, otherwise we'll return true. The index node, so it's the node that we have. From faux ECS libs YAML, faux ECS YAML index generator, okay. I imagine it's going to be something along the lines of target link libraries faux engine. YAML. Control Shift B, go a lot faster, please. Okay. Failed. E dot what? General error. Okay. Let's give this a go. See what happens. Hmm. Engine's all the way over there. So this just didn't even get called. Okay, it's great. So I guess I've just never even reached that point, right? I just never call it. Cool. Load state data. Okay, yeah, and then we have auto temp 2. We're gonna have a course group state. Data state. The data E. Wait, yeah, what on earth did happen to the rest of the stuff? You know what? There it is. Right? There it is. Ah, I had it stashed. Okay, group state, that, and ECS groups. There's no, yeah, there is no constructor, so that's fine. Groups 2, it's an and, so that's good. No, not quite. Useful undeclared identifier, state data dependency. Okay. Did I rename it or something? Oh, it's right there. Oh, because it's a CPP file now. So it's no it's anonymous namespace. So yeah. Yeah. Call implicitly deleted copy constructor of that. Reference. This is also reference. Let's get rid of the examples and the tests for the moment. What is this new thing? Did C make it update? Yeah, 320. Okay. Let's go to this point. And what was I trying to do? Yes, I was checking index generators. So ECS group, persistent. There's no new free IDs and anything like that. So we do that. Then it's 14 with a num recycle 2, 10, and 8. I believe are correct. Index data. That's not the index data I was looking for, apparently. Index data. 2, 10, and 8. Next IID is 14. Wonderful! And we return true. Okay. Next on the block would be actually importing the state data. Well, technically be the resources first, then the state data. If I recall correctly, it would be, resources are first, then state data can reference resources as well as each other. Resources must exist first. Or do they have to? Okay. Dependencies. Group that index data and then resources, and then I have state data. And of course, resources will be done in a particular order as well, be starting from the initial one up to the current one. And then the same thing for state data. So much, yeah, much like this. For data pools and resource pools. Yeah, okay. Dependencies, we do that. Dependencies for import group resources. Okay. Maybe something like this, I think. Now, at this point, group dependencies would be. Like, maybe this is something I just want to keep. Actually, no, at this point, before I get to this point, I need to do that thing where I generate that translation layer between whatever the group originally was and the new IDs. The old group IDs to the new group IDs. On a per, okay. That would be used on both, wouldn't it? It wouldn't really matter. It would be converted correctly either way. Or would it? Would it? Because, yeah, what if you added a dependency halfway through for new data? Yeah. So then this would have to still remain in place. Yeah. Don't just do it every time when you're inside, I guess. So what we'd have to do is on import, something like this, return true. We'd also need to be able to return f back out if. Fails, return false, then we'd have to make sure all the resources we did get are then properly cleared. This will be a new empty function. Okay, so let's see what we got. Struct. Yeah, so basically source and target. There we go. Basically be this. Generate group translations. Takes in, starts off with the this. Dependencies, we gotta do this. And we want to return this vector of these guys. Translations, we return translations. Would we want to return a false? Whatever. We can actually do dot reserve. Initial size of that thing, then we in place back group translation. And then we'd also need interesting. Does it not have like a groups function anymore? Group. No, it does. This argument has type const, but method is not marked const. Really? It's not, is it? take me to, thank you. Okay. First of all, we need to actually do something a bit smarter. We're going to actually check to make sure. To do a thing and return a false. So yeah, we need a bool. We need to change this to be a that. Otherwise, we do that. We return true. Okay. Got that. Return true down there. What do we need? We needed dependencies, we needed the CS groups, and we needed the translation list that we were about to create down here. Pass in the dependencies. We're going to pass in the groups. Do the same thing for these. We'd also need a couple of const expression. Be like what? It's just resources, right? Okay, state data and resources. No, add an S, resources directory path, resources. Okay, the other thing that was required is the target group. I guess that would be like one of the first things, really. Group, name, target group. Target group, target group, okay. Group translations, that's not working. Candidate function requires four, but three were provided. Really? Oh, yeah, I didn't need it there. Here. Yes. I don't. Oh, yeah. No. I need to get the dependencies for the group I'm inside right now, the subgroup. Back up. This means we don't really need group dependencies. Top level group, that is. We need to go through it per group, though. IT.group. ECS groups. Then I need to. Okay, where did I generate? I got the import state. These from file, which is this. Okay, group dependencies. I need the target group and I need the path of it. That's what I need. File system. Target group path. So it becomes this, that. Don't need this. It's instead the group dependencies. Okay, and then down here, it.path, right? Okay, these are IT.group, but this is just the top level group, so what would it be? Persist. No, don't know this. Okay, oh, ECS groups. Persistent. And then the path is literally this, right? The YAML path. Okay. Let's see how this goes. Or at this point. Go inside. Yeah, that's great. Group dependencies will be the same dependencies as this. DBA, which should be the same as DBA. Wonderful. 0, 2, 3. 0, 2, 3. Okay, generate the group translations. Hold on. Okay. I'm sorry, why is it getting shifted over by a line? Must be some weird op. Hold on. One debug, right? Yeah. Strange. Go to that point. Then we'll stop. Okay. So, what was this? The target group was 0, which is group A, I think. Yeah. There's nothing in here, so there'll be no group dependencies, no group translations, so whatever. Next group is target group 2, which is the data B, which does have a dependency, does not? No, it does not. Okay. Next will be D, which does, right? On both A and B, which are different. So compared to the data E, translation 0 and then 1. Okay. Group dependencies, we got 0, 1. Those are the dependencies here. It's great. There's no translations. That's not a good result. So this is the one with ECS group 2. Interesting. It's data D. Okay, now we're here. We're here. We've got dependencies. Got 2. 0 to 1. Okay, great. First target group, iterator name, the data A exists, right? Did I not actually input? Oh, yes. Okay, I never put the dependency data in place, did I? Check transitive dependencies that we set up. that's this. Wonderful. We do that. False, okay. Plus new group ID. Now, at this new point, where was I? Here, okay. So, one thing I want to check is that for M groups, we have 0, we have 1, 2, 3. 0, 2, 3, yeah. Then we go inside. This is the wrong group, isn't it? Yes, state data B, state data D. Okay, here we go. Target group, it does exist. Got group translations. Target source. 0 goes to target 0, A to A, and that one to that, which is the normalized value. It's a non-normalized value. Okay, yeah. Three, right? The data D, resource groups, M groups. We got group 3. Got to get that. What's the group ID? It's that. That doesn't look like the group translation value at all. B. Oh no, I was reading the one wrong one, wasn't I? Hmm. 805, 53, whatever, and 0. Five, three, six, eight, whatever. Okay. Then this is 80. Yeah. So it is right. Yeah. Okay. I'm just the idiot. Okay. Do I actually need to import resources? Like, do I actually have to do it? Pretty sure the answer is no. Yeah. I just need the state data, really. Just make sure that this is the same. Groups are des resources are designed to be loaded. On the fly, I guess. Turn true. So if okay, I need to take a quick break and grab a drink. It's nearly an hour in. Okay. All right, so importing group state data. So I need some actual state to import. To start with, no and no. The data E had. Nothing. I thought I had something. Oh no, I had it here. Okay. So let's say I have an entity, whatever that is, an entity, whatever that is. Okay. These entities. Okay. Do I want to actually like separate entity ID and group ID at this point? Like when I save it, so that they're always normalized ID. Yes, because if they're normalized IDs, like starting from zero, then that means I can modify, let's say, the size of a group ID in future and not break all these guys. Okay. But that also would mean so let's say state data. How do we say it? We'd say like so maybe we just do like group ID 0. And then have the index ID. Whoops. And we just say like dot YAML. Then the second one will be 0.1 dot YAML. Something like that. What would group ID? Group ID would always be the maximum. Okay. Rather, no. Okay, no. No. We have two sets. So that would be like if we are modifying from one of our dependent groups. Otherwise, if it's just native, It'd just be like 0.yaml. Just the index. Oh, it will only have the prefix, you know, what would it be like 0.0? Can I do 0.0? Because yeah, okay. I think I'll work with this one. Yeah, I'm kind of liking that. And then inside, we still have to have like entity ID 0. It would have to match. If it doesn't match, then it would fail. And the same thing for this. It'd be like 0 and entity ID 1. And be similarly down here, something like that. And we have another one which would be like 9.yaml. Okay, because I can't read this at all. This is unreadable. This is unusable. Otherwise, then we'd have something like this. So position 3D is the thing that I already had a while back. We'd also have like editor IDs, I guess. Whatever. First of all, let's make sure that this works. So. By this point, when we're loading this, we've already loaded the sub state groups, I guess. So let's go back to this. How exactly we go about this? We have the target group path, which is, so let's say that you're into the data E, then everything we'd have to, okay, now I need to figure out how to use standard file system. Use that standard file system that iterate through. Can these be directories? I mean, they could be directories, but they would be transparent. I have to iterate through and just load all these files. So find recursive directory iterator. What's this? Do. But does not visit the subdirectories. Okay, that's close. And the recursive one. Is that 17? Wait, what's already deprecated? U8 path. Char or char AT. Yeah, okay, makes sense then. All right, how do we create this? Huh. Okay. So it's literally And it'd be made up of target group path slash state data directory. Like that, I presume. Okay. For auto p. No. Okay, no. Okay, what does it produce then? Visiting that, which becomes path.native, I presume that this is what that's. Okay, what is this? Directory entry. Okay. Let's go back. Directory entry. Okay, how do I get your name? File system. Just file dot, so dot path. Directory entry. Nothing? Really? Or is it like there's just nothing there, I guess? Target group path. Oh, that's yeah, okay. Of course, if the directory is empty. Okay, so make sure. Can be empty if new. If not standard file system. Exists of this. We just return true. No problem. There's just nothing in there. Whatever. We can put a warning though. know, state data found, we'll just say, you know, it's target group. Name. Okay. And then we return true. We're done here. Okay. The state data A, no data found. That's great. Really? Just that was it? State data A, no state. What about E? Did E not happen? Interesting. Target group path is data state, the data E, which will then go into state data. Oh, it's an empty. Oh, yeah. No bloody wonder. No, I need that and this. Okay, since we're just reusing this over and over. Target dependencies. Nope, we don't do it there. We do it here. And then we do it here. Actually, yeah, there's only two times. Okay. 090001. Okay. Looks about. That looks very nice. Okay. This would quickly get like ridiculous for faux logging. Actually, we'll just leave it there for the moment. Actually. Okay. We're here. We've got the path. If we have another directory inside of it, what does that look like? It looks like a thing. So we need to actually filter out. Is regular file. Can I just put that in? Yes, I can. And then we'd have to return false. Okay, let's just say that these are here in a subdirectory. You can somewhat organize, but what really matters is the numbers. Okay, parse ret val equals. Do I have a ret val in here? Yes, I do. Something like that, which is now a dir entry, the path. File path. I've got to say, if it's not a regular file. Then at this point, I would have to add these dependency node, save state data dependencies. Okay. Save state data. Here we go. That'd be separate. That'd be separate. I need to be able to read this. Okay. Parse the following from group entity ID information to match against. I think. I mean, actually, would this really matter? Do I really want to do this matching system? Or do I want to actually have, like, you can name it whatever you want? Or even like a mixture. Not everything would have. Okay, for the moment I will. Until it becomes unwieldy. No, that's the thing. It would become unwieldy really quickly, wouldn't it? If I allow arbitrary names, then I can like organize the subdirectories for like, oh, you know, these are the entities that belong in the town. These are the entities that belong in, I don't know, in the sky entities, sky objects, ground objects, underground objects, water objects, whatever. Then I can organize it like that. And then have somewhat more descriptive names than just numbers. So no, I will not have that. It just has to be a regular file. Doesn't matter what. It doesn't even have to be closely named. So what we do? But it has to have. Acquired entity ID. It needs to have that. Actually, no, first. What I'm really doing is I need to rip up open the YAML file. I could just what this and that and then go into file path in. That and then we try to parse. Node, and then we'd have, I don't know, the pools, position pool, data pools. So this be this import state data from file. Return false. If it fails, it just kills the whole thing. Because that means most probably something catastrophic is happening on the file system, and you don't want to load anything else either, for fear of corrupting anything else. When you attempt to resave. I think I need to fix up my nomenclature as well. It's getting a bit confusing between group state data, YAML state data, entity state data. Like it's all state, all data is state, really. It's just redundant. Okay, I need a quick moment to think about this. Okay. You know what? No, state data pools. Entity state, group state, group. Yeah. Whatever. For the moment, what matters is we're going to have a function. It's going to be like this. Whatever. Like that. And it's going to be along the lines of void. YAML read. What would it be, auto? Now we can return something at least. The group ID doesn't really matter because it'll be brought in. Actually, it does, unless it has a group ID. Okay. I think. For entity ID. Now we can return the whole thing. Or at least the idea of it. The idea of the thing we created, we added, we parsed. Returns nothing. What does it do? Returns entity ID. If it fails, it'll throw an exception anyways. Presumably we'll also have another one that'll be reading. That is reading. I need to write. That. Okay, what really matters though at the moment is this. Well, not really, it's just this. being overwritten, okay? Index ID. Node name is index ID. Node. Okay, that was a sneeze. Edit that out. If we did actually find one to read, then what we need to do is a targeted group ID. And then from this point on, we just kind of have some kind of weird thing for, we'd establish a pattern for the other types of data, which for the moment is just position, I think. And we'll read position 3D node, which at the moment I don't have any of the fancy parsing stuff to go along with it. With the index ID, right? Something like that. this fails, then it'll go into this. Okay, hold on. Actually, while I'm here at that. So we have the node with the targeted group ID. But then we need the, what was the targeted group ID? Do 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 do. There's a translation. There you are. Then I guess I just have to suck it up and put it down there, really. I'd also need import state data from file. The target group. So I guess this needs to be public knowledge now. Okay, so that gets us back into here. So let's give this one a go. Crap. If there's no index ID, okay. If it fails, animal state data, okay. Okay, yeah, so this is still safe. I just need to update. Close to the right. And failure, I did not even add it to be piled in yet. What group are I don't even know what file I'm in. What's the node? Zero. So this should not exist, so it's zero. Bad conversion. Okay. Typed bad conversion. Really? For thingy zero. Oh, yes, you are correct. But that's actually also very interesting. This was not caught by my okay, actually. Whoa. This wasn't caught by my parsing thing at all. Why not? Go into here and have a look. Keep going. Okay, we're here. We go inside. Reading optional. Great. Faux YAML exception. Okay. But it threw. What? Okay, yeah, I'm gonna read optional. For UN64T is in here. YAML read optional right here. Okay, we're inside of here. That's great, right? We're inside of this. Do 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 do. We're inside. We have a subnode. It's a real. Oh, yes, I see.
I tried to parse it as a standard string, even though it's not even a string, it's a whole subnode. Okay, I need to open that up. YAML CPP. Show me. If node dot type. Okay. So I can do that. I can do this kind of little switch in here. Here. I think. Switch node dot type. Do this instead. Sequence map undefined. Okay. It's a map type node. Throw that out, return. Nice. Now, I wonder if this also applies to like GLM vec parsing. Read optional. Read acquired. Required. No, not found to parse as that.
Read off, no, it devolves to the regular tiny basic type. So that's actually fine. So you can actually just work with that. Yeah, that. Okay, back to this. Yeah, we'll read position three. Yes, this fun stuff. What's time? It's nearly 2 hours, so I should actually probably leave it here and come back tomorrow. Figure out how to bring for I need to be able to pull through the data and resource pools and put the data in and actually create a proper node for this probably. I think how do I write pod parsing? Write optional. Node and yeah, maybe. All right, well, I'll call it there. Cheers.